Welcome back. Even as our security forces fight terrorists in the Sunjuwan army camp, Netas indulged in a massive political fight instead. A day after pro-Pakistan slogans were raised in the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly, now Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has decided to blame Pandit Nehru's policies for the current situation in the state. Also adding on to it, RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat seems to have claimed that if it comes to a warlike situation, he will have his forces as well mobilized within 3 days. Congress has slammed the government for its failed policies in the J&K state.
ये अटैक कांग्रेस की जो नीतियां रही हैं जिसकी वजह से कश्मीर की समस्या हमारे सामने है पंडित नेहरू के जमाने से उसका एक प्रत्यक्ष असर है. हमारी सेना में पर्याप्त ताकत भी है रणनीति भी है उसका उत्तर देने की. सन 2017 में जितने आतंकवादी हमने मारे हैं हमारी सैनिकों ने वो अनप्रेसिडेंटेड है और इसलिए जहां युद्ध टाइप स्थिति होती है वहां इस तरह के राजनीतिक बयान किसी राजनीतिक दल को शोभा नहीं.
अगर देश को जरूरत पड़े और देश का संविधान कानून कहे तो सेना तैयार करने को 6-7 महीना लग जाएगा. संघ के स्वयंसेवकों को लेंगे.
एक मुल्क से दूसरे मुल्क में लोग जाते हैं, काम करते हैं, इंडस्ट्री लगाते हैं. खुदा करे कि एक दिन ये सार्क के जो मुल्क है इनमें भी वही चीज आ जाए जिसमें कि हम लोग इकट्ठे मिल बैठ के सोच सके, आगे बढ़ सके, तरक्की करें. हमारे बेकार बच्चे जो है, बच्चियां जो है, वो काम करें. हम लोग आसमान से बात करें. मैं वो दिन देखना चाहता हूँ.
We continue with our debate. Shabnam, lone lawyer, activist, also Kuldeep Khoda, former DGP JNK Police, and also, of course, Sushant, serene defense expert. Sushant, I mean, the sort of statements coming in from the political leadership, even the finance minister and the BJP consistently raising the Nehru issue now, 70 years, what is the BJP going to do? And in fact, I mean, if that is what you can answer first.
Pooja, you know, this is precisely what the problem is. You know, for example, the sound clips you were playing, I think it was Mr. Farooq Abdullah in the end. Now, he wants open borders between India and Pakistan that people can come and go, the European Union model. But when you talk about an open border between India and mainland India and Kashmir, you know, a kind of xenophobia takes over almost all political parties in Kashmir when it comes to things like Article 370, Article 35A, etc. You know, the kind of xenophobic comments which we see in Kashmir are before us, and Mr. Umar Abdullah and Farooq Abdullah and their ilk have been on the forefront of protesting against those moves, number one. Number two, when Shabnam Lone keeps talking about, you know, this political problem, 70 years, etc., etc., people should start defining what exactly they mean by it. You know, this talking in the air without coming down to specifics. Now, I want to know that at least over the last 15-20 years, there has been democracy in Kashmir. People are free to elect their governments. If those governments, which are representatives of the Kashmiri people, are not able to perform very well, then don't blame it on you know, the Indian constitution or the Indian state.
Shabnam?
That is a problem of the Kashmiri people, and they need to look for better leadership, number one. Number two, you know, this kind of deflection which happens to justify people like stone pelters. And let me just say one thing. Stone pelters and stone pelting is not a peaceful activity. Anybody who says that stone pelting is a peaceful way to protest, then I challenge them that I will come to their house and pelt stones at their house, and they should accept it lying down.
Shabnam,
and they should
want
not protest against it because that's a peaceful protest. So this is the kind of nonsense, and this is the kind of, you know, conflation which is happening in Kashmir, which is also giving wind to the kind of separatist narratives inside Jammu and Kashmir. And this is where we are not able to change the narrative or the discourse in Jammu and Kashmir. People like Mrs. Lone, who have lost a lot, her father got assassinated by the terrorists, and yet, you know, they play this ambivalent game, the
Shabnam, why don't you interject and respond to what Sushant is saying?
Justify in one form or another the kind of stuff which is happening. They have to give this up.
Shabnam Lone.
Okay, Sushant, first of all, it's Miss Lone. It's not Mrs. Lone. Okay.
Okay, now, not getting
all,
into the pretexts.
Now, is this the LOC firing? The LOC firing every day. Pakistan kills soldiers. Is the common Kashmiri involved in it? You just tell me, just 2 days before you had a missile attack from Pakistan, Captain Kudu.
Madam, again, you know, you're trying to deflect the issue.
They blew them
to bits. Madam, you're again trying to deflect the issue.
And the BJP says that it is the most peaceful. Are we involved in that? No, are we involved in that? Is the common Kashmiri involved in that?
You talk about the issue.
I'm saying as a
Kashmiri,
we cannot help it. The common Kashmiri is helpless. No, you just tell me what Pakistan, what have you done to Pakistan? If Pakistan is the mother of all problems, sir, if they are killing soldiers, leave alone Kashmiris. You call us supporters of stone pelters, you call us terrorists, okay, fine. But if they are killing soldiers day in and day out, what is your consistent plan and policy? What are you doing? What do? You go and have business with them? Pakistan is your most favored nation. You have a normal high commission with them. You play cricket with them.
Sushant, she does have a fair point.
Movies and
that
you have
the Indian government also keeps attacking Pakistan.
Is this your response?
But it does seem that by itself.
And you blame the Kashmiris.
Okay, Pooja, the point is making.
Why can't you have a downgraded high commission? Why do you have policy with them? Why do you have friendship with them? On what basis?
Totally messed up. We are not clear about what we want to do in Pakistan. And it's not just this government. For the last 70 years, we have not been clear. On that, I completely agree with Shabnam Lone. But see, there are two parts of what is happening in Kashmir. One part is how do we deal with Pakistan, and we need clarity on that issue. We need policy consistency on that issue, and the kind of wishy-washy and the kind of hail fellow well-met kind of nonsense which we've been seeing over the last 70 years has to end. It should have ended 30 years back, but it is still time that we end that nonsense. That is one part of it where I'm in complete agreement with her. You know, the other part of it is what is happening inside the Kashmir state. The state of Jammu and Kashmir. And that is where I'm afraid activists and politicians like Shabnam Lone and others are not clear. You know, they try and hedge their bets. They try and disguise their narratives.
No, I don't agree with you.
That is the kind of thing which has to end. They have to take clear unambiguous positions. And they don't take it.
No, that is wrong, Sushant. I do not agree with you. No, I do not agree with Sushant on this basis. Is that BJP is in alliance with PDP? Now PDP's links with Syed Ali Shah Gilani. It is well known. Why doesn't he say that the present BJP and PDP? Now I have a suggestion, and it is an honest suggestion. Have president's rule. Don't give power to the Abdullahs and the Muftis. We might be able to have a solution in Kashmir if you do not give this sugar sweet spice power to somebody in Kashmir. All together find a solution. Have president's rule. I will not mind as a Kashmiri if there is a central rule.
I just want to take an update from Gaurav Savant. He has been sending us ground reports from Jammu. Gaurav, you're listening to this debate. Shabnam Lone has just now in fact said that she wants to suggest even a president's rule. Sushant Sareen says there needs to be more political unity, even by activists getting together, compared to what they usually say, that there is a lot of ambivalence. How are you reacting to the situation there? What is the update?
Just very disappointed because on ground I'm seeing our brave soldiers, and this is a fresh lot. So yesterday morning this counter-terror operation started. Yesterday morning you had a firefight here where you had Pakistani terrorists breach security, perhaps taking shelter. Politicians of this country permitted illegal immigrants to settle here, outsiders to settle in some parts here, apparently. And that is what sources are telling India Today, that these terrorists took refuge here, they stayed here, they wrecked the area, they breached the perimeter fence, went in, there was a firefight. And Shabnam Lone or Sushant Sareen or Kuldeep Koda or I, every Indian should be alarmed that Jammu and Kashmir light infantry, fellow Indians, residents of Kupwara, they were killed and injured in the first firefight. Civilians, for army wives, army children, they were injured. There's a young army child who's battling for his life with a bullet injury to the head. And we are indulging in this kind of politics. Well, politics can get them thus far and no further. Beyond that, you know, there is another generation of India that is coming up, which will not live up to this sucking up to Pakistan attitude at all. It will not do in this 21st century India. Well, this was democracy growing. Now when I see our soldiers go in And, you know, they're fighting for this country. They don't hail from Jammu and Kashmir. Some of them did. I spoke to some soldiers. They're from Tamil Nadu. They're fighting in Kashmir for India. But our netas don't learn this India first. So it is a little alarming.
Yes.
It is a little worrying. But perhaps we will see this change. That father in Kupwara had the best point. A father in Kupwara says he's proud his son made the supreme sacrifice for India. There was no Kashmir versus Delhi. It was one India. And perhaps one generation down the line, there will be a Kashmir that will realize that.
Well, in fact, let's listen in to the father, because apparently that is the word that the nation wants to go ahead with and should really. In fact, it's a father, a grieving father who's just lost his son. Kuldeep Khoda, one quick word from you. When at this juncture, the Jammu and Kashmir police are losing their life because a Pakistani terrorist is escaped with the help of local terrorists, and then the stone pelters also seem to get amnesty, does it at any level demoralize the policemen as well on field, the soldiers as well, as to political parties are willing to be humane to everybody apart from the ones in the uniform?
It absolutely exposes that we have, as Sushant said, that we have no policy on Pakistan. We have absolutely no policy on Kashmir also. Sometimes you arrest the pelters and then you release them. You forget about everything. You have to have a consistent policy on dealing with Kashmir. Last year, you made a big expose on funding of terrorists.
Yes.
And NIA made some good efforts in unearthing the entire issue. They tackled that particular problem which you had exposed and some of its offshoots. But beyond that, they have also stopped. We are not following the things consistently and dealing with all channels of funding in totality. The funds are still flowing. The radicalization is still going. The imams from all over are flocking to Kashmir and radicalizing the society there. We have no surveillance on the madrasas, what they are doing and what they are teaching. And we have to be consistent on Kashmir policy. We have to be consistent on Pakistan policy. And it has to be framed. It has to be addressed. And Pakistan has to be totally attacked. Sometimes we talk about Pakistan, we talked about in this water treaty last year.
But sir, my question is, if in 2017, that is last year, almost 200 militants were killed. There was heavy crackdown in a joint operation by the police, the CRPF, the army. And yet, if you say terrorism has increased, who is to be blamed?
I reiterate that the police and the security forces are doing a tremendous job. They are losing their lives. The terrorists have been targeted in a big way, but the effort on other fronts is missing.
Yes.
That's the main issue. The politicians are speaking in different voices, though all of them say that they are for the integrity of country. But at the same time, the type of suggestions and solutions they try to give, they only create more confusion than solving the problem. And sometimes you don't know whether they are speaking for India or for Pakistan. That is a big problem.
Very important. That's an important point coming in from a former senior officer. Final word to you, Shabnam Lone. I understand that with the first time stone pelters, if the government is even considering amnesty, it can be considered as a humane approach, probably to calm down some nerves of the youth. But at a larger level, the voice seems very divided amongst the activists, amongst the politicians. And it does seem, and I'm asking you this question because you've seen both sides. What is the next step? I mean, I wouldn't want to sit here discussing another attack on the army camp with soldiers getting killed and families getting injured.
See, Kashmir has external and internal dimensions. So the external and internal dimensions means that you need to have policies on two platters. The Pakistan policy as well as the internal policy.
Should we just end talks yet again? Do you support ending talks yet again with Pakistan?
Having been released... No, I am saying the time for talks is over. What do you want to talk now? Every day soldiers are getting killed. Every day people are getting killed. What talks do you want to have? You were not able to book Hafiz Saeed. Till date, you were not able to get him back, even though he is involved in the Mumbai terror attack. So will Pakistan accept that they send terrorists? What do you want to talk
about? Fair enough. Sushant Sareen, final word.
To get killed now.
The Bharatiya Janata Party can blame Congress, can blame Nehru for all they want. But the fact is, they are in center, they are in the union government. They are in the state as well. And yet, it does seem like sometimes all we hear are talks, and that there will be a befitting reply. but the situation remains the same.
No, Pooja, really, I think I'm sick of this hearing of a befitting reply and all of that, or kadi ninda and what have you. You know, I think we are all up to our necks in this kind of condemnation. I think we are looking for action. The government has taken some action in the past, the surgical strikes, or for that matter, you know, even on the LOC, a very robust action has been taken.
You mean but a military action, it, or are you saying diplomatic cut-off?
I think we need to look at this problem in a more strategic sense on how to handle Pakistan. Sorry?
Are you referring to a military action or a diplomatic cut-off?
Yes, sir. It has taken you 70 years, sir. 70 years and thousands of people.
No, I'm referring to, I don't say that you have to take a military action which is to fight a war. I don't think we need to go down that road just yet. That might be something we might have to exercise later on. But on the diplomatic front also, I think there's a lot more that can be done.
And,
you know, for example, when the government of the day lets a bill fall which targets Pakistan and names it as a terror sponsoring nation, then it raises questions of whether there is this nostalgia or some kind of romance that even these guys have, that they want to have some kind of a modus vivendi going on with Pakistan. I think those questions have to be answered now. You know, this business that we are taking very strong action is all very well, but where is it leading to? What is the larger game plan? And that is not clear.
I do hope that the politicians, if at all they are watching this panel right now, there were some suggestions as well that have come in, and I really appreciate joining of Shabnam Lone, Sushant Sareen and Kuldeep Khoda. And it is imperative that at least some policy, some action at least goes out as a message to the public that is watching its soldiers dying in Jammu today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.